Today we're making a game that will unexpectedly crash your computer. So I'm just hoping my computer can handle it. It's the most crappiest thing. So what I was thinking for this game is it's going to be a cat from scratch. And he's going to be chasing a bunch of yarn all over the screen. Let's name this game Cat Yarn Game. No, that sounds weird. How about I Need Yarn? Yeah. Let's rename the Scratch Cat to Kitty.
Good Kitty.
Why not? Now let's give him some good looks, because, you know, collecting yarn is something you need to be good looking for, I guess. So let's give him small pupils, so it looks like he's super excited to collect all this yarn. And maybe then we can give him some long arms to collect them easier, I guess. No, that does not look good at all. Let's give him long legs, then he can move around faster. I don't know. Then now I'll create the movement script. Pretty simple. Not too hard. Except for this one part. I don't know what I was doing. I just didn't know what I did wrong. I'll let you figure that out. But now that we have the movement working, let's go ahead and create our yarn sprite. It's looking pretty good, if you know what I mean. Not really. It's really bad. We'll fix it later. But first, let's actually do the code for the yarn first. So we're gonna make a weight and pick random block, and then let's make a variable and call it yarn spawner so that we can change how often it'll spawn. So we can spawn faster to crash your computer faster, you know. So now every time that the variable will tick off, it'll minus one to the variable. Okay, now it should be working. Let's see. Yep. All right. Now I think we just need to make the yarn actually spawn. I forgot to make it show and actually create a clone at the beginning. So let's do that real quick. Okay, I think it is working now. I think now we just should actually add the point system. So I'm gonna make a montage and you'll just watch that because I don't want to talk through the whole thing. Now the game is technically done, but let's test out if it'll crash our computer or just scratch limits just will shut it down. They're actually spawning faster now. Let's see if my computer can handle it. Here they come. It's like every second. Oh my gosh, what the heck? There's so many. Oh, it's not doing anything so far. I think it needs to spawn faster. This is just satisfying, if anything. Yeah, let's fix this.
And this, what you doing, is to go even further beyond.
So yeah, it definitely makes your computer very laggy, but it just isn't that fun. So why don't we add another element to this game? Enemies.
Okay.
Just kidding, because I'm too lazy. Let's just redo all the art and make it as smooth as possible. Alright, I finished the game and added a ton of new stuff to make the game more enjoyable. Also, let's just test it out and I'll show you what this game is like. Well, I think it turned out pretty good for a small little game that I was not intending to make that big. And I think it definitely will not crash your computer, but it will make it very laggy while you're playing it, especially at the beat drop. But if you want to play it for yourself, a link is in the description, and I'll see you guys next time. See you later, fancy hats.
What are you doing in my swamp? What are you doing in my swamp?
Holy!